What's up, YouTube? This is Slide8Fry here. So I'm just going to do a quick react video. It's Halloween. I'm thinking of even doing a live stream of Dead by Daylight, of me playing the game for the first time. But I don't know how much time I'll have for that or not. Let's do a react from a channel. I've been meaning to actually do react videos too. But this might be the only one I ever do. I'm just going to probably binge the rest of the videos on my own. It's from a really hilarious Canadian named ADoseOfBuckley. You gotta check out his channel, it's really funny.
There's three holidays in the US that have a whole shitload of songs associated with it.
Yeah, there are.
Christmas, of course. Mm-hmm. St. Patrick's Day, mm-hmm. when the Dropkick Murphys and Flogging Molly make most of their streaming income. And Halloween. Now, there's basically four or five songs you have to play every Halloween. The Monster Mash, Thriller, Ghostbusters,
yeah.
The Time Warp, and the greatest Halloween party song, Oingo Boingo's Dead Man's Party. Because
what?
Oingo Boingo was the greatest thing to come out of the 80s, and anyone who disagrees is simply incorrect.
I disagree.
And then, because Halloween parties last longer than 30 minutes and you get to pad out the playlist, there are a bunch of songs people recommend, like Shakira's She-Wolf, Rihanna's Disturbia, or AC/DC's Hell's Bells.
Hell's Bells makes sense.
Close enough. Now, I hosted Halloween parties for about 8 fucking years, and these are the 3 Halloween songs I could do with never hearing again. Number 3, Sheb Wooley, Flying Purple People Eater.
I haven't heard that song in ages.
Flying purple people eater sure looks strange to me.
This is a kid's song. Except, kids deserve better than this. Also, the song has nothing to do with Halloween, other than it's about some sort of monster who apparently literally eats purple people, as we'll find out in a second.
Yeah.
So I guess you should only be scared if you're suffering from cyanosis. No, he's not here to actually murder or eat anyone. He's got a different motive for his coming to Earth.
I said, Mr. Purple People Eater, what's your line? And he said, eating purple people, and it sure is fine. But that's not the reason that I came to land.
I wanna get a job in a rock and roll band.
The song then rips off two other novelty songs of the
1950s. Wow, that's weird.
The Royal Teens' Short Shorts.
We wear short shorts.
Oh, my God.
Little people eater.
And the Champs' Tequila.
Tequila.
Anyway, the song has a happy ending. He gets a gig on a TV show and doesn't murder a single individual, meaning that Phil Spector was a scarier monster in 50s music than the Flying Purple People Eater.
Okay.
Number 2 is the Fresh Prince and DJ Jazzy Jeff, A Nightmare on My Street.
What?
But when I got home and laid down to sleep, that began the nightmare on my street.
The new trend of songs
nightmare
being like
street.
2.5 minutes
yeah.
long is just fantastic when you look at shit like this. This atrocity is 6 minutes long, and I never really understood why it existed. I guess Will Smith wanted a song for every occasion. It's summer,
that's way too
you got
long.
Summertime. Having a Western theme party? Play Wild Wild West. Doing something spy themed? You can use Men in Black. Mom
yeah.
and Dad won't let you have a party? Sulk to Parents Just Don't Understand. Planning on getting jiggy with it? Play Switch. But anyway, the song, which came out in August, prime Halloween time, apparently was made
wow.
for Nightmare on Elm Street 4.
Makes sense.
And then the producers were like, no, this is too stupid even for this series of derivative cash-ins. So Will Smith was like, well, no sense in this going to waste. We'll just release it anyway.
Yeah.
The song is about Freddy appearing in the Fresh Prince's dreams. We get this frightening description of him.
He comes to me at night after I call into bed. He's burnt up like a weenie and his name is Fred. He wears the same hat and sweater every single day. And even if it's hot outside, he wears it anyway.
He wears a sweater even when it's hot. I can't imagine why the producers of a horror movie that they kind of wanted people to take seriously and think was scary didn't want to include this on the soundtrack.
Yeah,
anyway,
wow, that's
Freddy
really
then
bad.
Asks Will to team up with him to murder his friends.
I said, yo, Fred, I think you got me all wrong. I ain't partners with nobody with nails that long. Look, I'll be honest, man, this team won't work. The girls won't
beyond you, Fridge, your face is all burned. Will can't team up with him because it would hurt his chances to get girls.
Wow.
He doesn't seem to have any objections to the helping murder his friends part.
Yeah.
If Freddy could have, say, got Cindy Crawford to chug him like a Pepsi, and it turned out old Krueger was the wet dream master, he'd be breaking DJ Jazzy Jeff's records in half and trying to saw his fucking head off.
Wow.
The whole thing ends up as Will Smith's Freddy fanfic, and might be the first example of his rap song that describes the plot of the movie genre that Demi Adijuibe has mocked far better than I ever could. So, in the spirit of trick-or-treating, here's your treat. Go check out his Will Smith, Black Panther, Get Out, and Aladdin parody raps, as well as his Childish Gambino Lando parody. Anyway, the producers of Nightmare on Elm Street hated this song so much, they forced Will Smith to put a sticker on the song and a disclaimer at the beginning of the music video to say that it was not part of the soundtrack and is not authorized, licensed, or affiliated with the Nightmare on Elm Street films.
That's awesome.
That's when you know you've made a good song.
Yeah.
When the person you made it for makes you legally distance them from it.
Yeah, that's fucking awesome.
And the worst Halloween song is Aqua Halloween.
What? I never heard of this song.
The girl's voice from Aqua is the only thing truly terrifying here. I would rather listen to 10 minutes of the Baby Shark Kids having a slap fight with Alvin and the Chipmunks than nearly 4 minutes of Aqua for any reason. So obviously someone thought, there aren't enough Halloween songs that you can play at a rave in the early 2000s.
Okay.
So this dancey piece of shit got made. And it's just a huge mess containing references to Friday the 13th. Scream with the phone calls. And the most horrifying reference, their own fucking music. Yes, I think it's supposed to be a clever mashup of the Candyman horror series and Aqua's own Lollipop.
Oh, that song. I remember that song.
But it's just so fucking cheesy. And then at the end, they're like, okay, we gotta jam in a few more references to Halloween from this list of words we wrote down. We still have pumpkin, candlelight, children, and horror movies that take place at school. What can
okay,
we do
sure.
with that? Nailed it, guy from Aqua, who for some reason put on this scary voice, even though his regular fake-sounding deep voice would have worked just as well. On Halloween night in the depths of hell, it's said that they play this song on loop while they stick candy corn up your dick hole and force you to chew Kerr's molasses kisses or Tootsie Rolls until all your teeth are pulled out and your mouth is just a bloody ball of teeth and taffy. They say the song is the worst part of the experience. And my only honorable mention goes to the people who play Zombie by the Cranberries at Halloween parties. A song about the Troubles, the Irish Civil War between the IRA and the Protestants. Because it just says zombie a bunch of times.
That's terrible.
It's not about actual zombies, you goofy fucks. It's a song written in response to two children being murdered by improvised bombs.
Wow,
fun
that's
for
horrible.
All parties.
That's fucked
all
up.
All right, Aqua, remind us again what day it is.
Ah, quit zooming. Great, the webcam fucked up again. Anyways, that was quite a blast to watch. I got a few things I gotta say though. So I'm probably not going to make any other Adosa Buckley React videos, and unless this one happens to get a lot of views and I feel like, oh, maybe it would be worthwhile to make some more. But anyways, check out Adosa Buckley. He's really hilarious. He's got a lot of funny shit. One of my favorite videos is actually from 2014, where he talks about the release of Super Smash Bros. On 3DS at the time. And he rants about how Nintendo seems to think that all their fans are morons because they named the game Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS, and then named the game that came out the following month Super Smash Bros. For Wii U, and mentioned a bunch of other things of proving why Nintendo seems to baby its fans. That's one of my favorites. The video that introduced me to A Dose of Buckley, though, was the 420 one, where he talks about how pathetic it truly is to just celebrate a day of smoking weed all the time, celebrating what you already do every day, stoner. But anyways, moving on, check him out. Prop 22, please, if you're in California, please vote yes on Prop 22. It must pass. I want to remain an independent contractor, not an employee. I want to work my own hours at my own convenience, and I know I'll make more money as an independent contractor than at an hourly wage as an employee. Please check out some of my other React videos, and check out some other videos of mine. I might do a live stream of my first time playing Dead by Daylight. Still, I'm not sure whether I will or not, though. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Click that bell icon to add me notifications.